Hi, I'm Scott. In this video, I'm going to go over how you replace a PTO electric clutch on a Craftsman mower. In this video, I'll go over the process, how I identified that I needed to replace the PTO clutch on my Craftsman mower. This process will work for most mowers that are Craftsman or like Craftsman, like a Poland or YTD, that have an electric PTO clutch. I'll cover in detail on how to remove and install the serpentine belt that's associated with your transmission that allows you to drive your tractor around your yard. I'll go over in detail on how to remove and reinstall the engine pulley and electric PTO clutch. I'll also go over the tools and supplies I needed and how much this project costs and where I got my parts from. All right, let's get started. Showing the old PTO electric clutch, and right here is the bearings from the top. If I pull that off, that just fell off when I took it apart. You'll notice that a whole bunch of bearings are missing. So this thing was in terrible shape, and that's what caused it all to lock up. It was time for a new electric PTO clutch. All right, this video is just an example. Here's the bearings. They're the pack bearings on my new PTO clutch. And here's what the bearings look like for my old PTO clutch. Bunch of them missing. Here was the cover. I pulled this thing apart off the engine pulley. It was just sitting under like that. And as you can tell by the angle of this thing, it's all compressed and warped. It was definitely done. So we'll see how the new one holds up over time. This video segment, I just wanted to give you a quick review. Here's my old clutch. I'm twisting it and it's not spinning. Here's my new clutch. And look how easy it spins on the ground. So this one is definitely old and jacked up. So its days are gone. Oops, look, that just all fell out just then when I turned it over. But it was done. So on with the new PTO clutch. At this part of the installation, I've taken my anti-seize lubricant, which is kind of interesting. It's a gray paste. And I've placed it on the shaft for my idle pulley. And I've also placed it on the shaft, the drive shaft inside the engine underneath of it. So I'm gonna dry fit these and make sure everything fits, and then we'll put it all together. All right, we're looking underneath the mower, and right there you can see the drive shaft, and it looks gray because I put that anti-seize paste on it. So I want to show you what that looks like before I put the PTO clutch on. Once again, right there, that's the drive shaft under the mower, and the gray look is that anti-seize paste I put on it. All right, I'm just going to dry fit. This is the idle pulley. I'm going to dry fit it. So what I just did is I rotated the drive shaft so we can see the slot right there. And that slot will line up with this slot too. And inside the shaft right there is a slot. So all these slots will line up. So I'm just gonna do a dry fit like that, make sure everything lines up, and that thing's gonna fit up there like that. So that's a dry fit and it's loose. That's good. Usually those are seized up. And then I'm gonna dry fit this end right here onto my new clutch. At this point, I've dry fitted my engine pulley to its shaft, has gone down here into my new clutch. And I'm just gonna finish dry fitting this whole unit onto the dry, onto that right there. And it's hitting, I don't know if you can see it, it's not going up, it's hitting right here. So I'm rotating this a little bit out of the way, and there it goes up. This piece right here sticks out and was hitting the steering column. So I rotated it, and this is more the position it should, it's gonna be in really like that, because this edge right here is gonna fit on that thing that's hanging down right there. But that's where we're gonna hook it up, and I'll put a bolt right here at the bottom, and I'll tighten that up and torque it up to 40 pounds. All right, here's a tip for you. When you put this thing together, I was showing both the engine pulley and the PTO clutch all installed together at one. It's like one piece, but really what you want to do is you put this engine pulley first. It's because you got to get this belt around it, the clutch belt. This is your drivetrain. This will drive your transmission. So what you want to do is, as you bring this up, the belt will go on top. Then you slip it in here, and with your left hand, you push the brake. See how that it's slipping now? You loosen that tension on that belt, and it'll allow you to put this up onto the drive shaft, and then you can let go, and then the belt tightens. When the belt tightens, by the way, it holds that part in place, so you're good to go. So, you know, it's basically another pair of hands, but that's really the only way to go get the thing on. It makes it a lot easier. So once again, if I'm facing the front of the mower, this is my right hand on the engine pulley. My left hand is on the foot brake pedal clutch. I'm pushing down with it. See the belt, we're watching right through here. So watch how the belt loosens up. You'll see these pulleys right here, this pulley move. It's losing all the tension on the belt, and that gives you plenty of room to get the engine pulley, the belt around that engine pulley, and put it in place. Now I'm letting go of my hand, you'll see everything go back into tension. Next, I'm putting the PTO clutch on. I actually have the bolt already through it. So I'm coming up through here. We're trying to line everything up. And I'm actually going to the other side of the mower because I need to look at this piece here when I line it up. All right, I'm on the other side of the mower. If I'm facing toward the front, I'm on the right-hand side of the mower. I'm gonna install the clutch. So, I've got the clutch in my hand. The tricky part here is this little groove piece here. I gotta make sure it inserts there. And I gotta make sure inside of this thing, that little notch there lines up in this notch. So I've gotta do some spinning around. So let's see how we're gonna do that. There we go. So I take this, I'm putting it toward this notch. And right now it's not lined up. So I'm spinning it until it lines up. I'm spinning this bottom piece until it lines up. And when it does, it'll slip right in. It wants to go in there. There we go. Okay, this piece is connected. I felt it slip in, and there it went right up. Now I've got the bolt, so I'm holding this up with my left hand, and I'm getting the bolt with my right hand. And you can see me slipping underneath there. I'm still pressing all this up because I don't want to lose that position. Now I'm just hand tightening. Let's see if I can get that in there. So I'm hand tightening that bolt just so everything stays up there. Okay, not too bad. Now I'm getting my socket wrench out. My socket wrench is 5/8. and we're just going to tighten it up. Now I have to tighten it. I'll hand tighten it, and I'll come back with a torque wrench, and I'll torque it to, I don't know, 40-45 pounds, which is not a lot. I could probably do it manually, get my impact wrench out and do it. You know, so I've got a lot of different options, but I'm just going to use my torque wrench and do it. I got the new PTO clutch installed. Above it up here, the engine pulley that's installed. And right here is the nut, the big bolt, and it's a 5/8 bolt. I have it installed. It's loose. I still got to tighten it up. I was able, I'm going to move the camera around and show you this. This is that part that I mentioned was, it keeps the clutch from rotating around. I'll put the technical name at the bottom of this video. So that's installed. A couple other things to show you is I've still got to, here's the wire. I still got to run that back to above the frame over to the other side by the engine and connect it up. And then I want to show you this piece over here. I've got mine for safety reasons. I have my mower jacked up in the front just so I can have more room underneath there. I've got a jack stand on this side. I couldn't get the jack stand on that side. This is part of the steering linkage. I didn't want to risk bending that, so I thought this would be good enough. I mean, I'm not in there banging around. And then just to show you back here, I have my wheels chalked. So make sure you do that before you climb underneath that mower. Okay, I got the engine pulley in and the serpentine belt around the engine pulley. I got the electric PTO clutch installed. I got the long bolt 5/8 inch nut driver installed. I used my impact wrench and double checked it with my torque wrench at 45 pounds. And so now I've got to hook up the PTO clutch. These are the wiring connector. This is coming from the new PTO clutch. Comes up through here. This is the normal. It's how it was before. Just to show you underneath the body, there's the new PTO clutch. Here's the wiring harness, and it goes up into that hole. And the main thing about this wiring is to make sure it's free of this belt, the engine pulley belt. And then right here is where we're going to be the grass cutting mower deck. Belt will go around here. So where it's at, it's free, loose. It's not going to hit anything. So we're good to go. All right, I connected the wiring connectors. At that point, I'll remove the jack stand from the front, lower the jack, remove the chalk from the tires, and it's pretty much good to go. I'll test it all out. I'll take this out of my air filter. If everything runs well, then I'll put the engine covering back over it, and then I'll install the mower deck on it. But I'll run it first, and then just to make sure the drive shaft and all that's working right. If that's all working, then I'll put the mower deck on it, and then we'll make sure it cuts grass. All right, looks like we got everything together. We put the engine covering on, or the engine cowling, the topper to cover the engine, and we got the mower deck installed. So we got those 5 pins installed. So the last piece of validation is I'm going to start it, and we'll turn on the PTO clutch, have the engine, the drivetrain drive the belt, which moves the blades, which will cut the grass. Okay, we got the PTO electric clutch installed. I got the serpentine belt installed. Now I'm just going to verify that my drivetrain turns, and I just grab this grill fan blade assembly atop of the flywheel cover and see how easy it turns. Well, before I did this, this thing was locked up. It would move like that. So I thought, well, it's either the engine's locked up, seized up, or it's my clutch is seized up on the drive shaft. But that was as much as it was moved. Now it easily turns around. So we're ready to start the mower. I don't have the mower deck installed. So it's just a serpentine belt. So I'll start the engine, see if I can drive it around. All right, that wraps up this video on how to remove and install a PTO electric clutch on your Craftsman mower. Hopefully you learned something from this video, and it will encourage you to go out and work on your Craftsman lawn tractor. To get automatic updates when I add content to my YouTube channel, click on the red subscribe button below. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up. If you dislike this video, hit the thumbs down. If you got any feedback, leave it in the comment section below. All right, thanks for watching. Have a great day, and go out there and cut your grass with that Craftsman lawn tractor.